Hello students, welcome to JCE Connect. We have started with the engineering geology lab solving maps. So in the last lab we have seen how to solve the map of horizontal beds. Today we will solve a map of inclined beds. So here there is a map in which you can see there are contour lines. Okay, the dotted lines are contour lines and the continuous lines, they are the bedding planes. So here there are A, B, C, D, E, F, G. These are the number of beds which are present in the given area. And here the contour value is 1000 at the center, 900, 800. So the values, contour values are decreasing away from the center. So this represents there is a hill, okay? And if you see the slope, this side the spacing of the contour is quite closer compared to this. So here you can see there is a steep slope and here there is a gentle slope on the western side. So with respect to north, if you say north, this is south, this is east, west. So eastern slope is steep and western slope is gentle. Now how to find whether the beds are inclined or horizontal? So if you remember the previous map wherein the contour lines and the bedding planes, they were parallel, but here the contour lines and the bedding planes, they are intersecting each other. So this means the beds are inclined. So when the beds are inclined, we are going to find out what is the strike direction and dip direction for such beds. So first we'll revise what is dip and strike. Okay, so here there is one figure you can see. So these are the beds which are present here. There is an outcrop shown, okay, exposure of the rock. Then here these beds are dipping in this direction. So this is the horizontal plane, which is an imaginary plane. So with respect to this horizontal plane, we are going to discuss what is dip and strike. So dip is the angle of inclination of these beds with respect to the horizontal plane. So here it is shown the angle, dip angle is 30 degree, means the angle between the bedding plane and the horizontal plane, that is called as the dip. And what is strike? This is the direction of the line which is formed by intersection of this plane, that is horizontal plane, and the bedding plane. So the direction of the line formed by intersection of the bedding plane and the horizontal plane is called as the strike direction. So here these two planes are intersecting along this direction. So this is the strike direction. So this is dip and strike. So on the map also we are going to find out what is the strike direction. So first we will mark all the intersections of the bedding plane and the contour lines. So here there are such intersections. So when you draw a strike line, okay, we have to see one point, that is, these are all the points wherever there are intersection of bedding plane and the contour line. So to solve the to find the strike direction, first we have to see the same contour, okay, same contour which is cutting the same bedding plane at two different points. So this is the first step in finding out the strike direction. So we have to see the same contour line cutting the same bedding plane at two points. Okay, so this is the first step. These are the two points. Then if you take one more line, so this contour line is cutting this bedding plane at this point and this point. So here if you want to join these two points, you have to draw a line like this. Okay, So here, so this is nothing but the strike direction. So if you draw a line here, you will get 3 points in a straight line. If you draw a line here, you are getting only 2 points. But here, I'll get 4 points. So I'll mark this line first, which is the reference strike line. Okay. Then remaining lines, all these lines we are going to draw parallel to this line. Okay. So how to draw the parallel lines? With the help of set square, or you can use the roller scale also. So here I'll keep my set square on the line, the strike line. Then take one more set square, okay, fix it here like this and just move it. Okay, you will be able to draw the strike lines. So here, wherever there are intersections, we are going to draw the strike lines. Okay, all the lines we are going to draw. So these are called as the strike lines. So these are all the strike lines. Wherever there are intersections, we are going to draw the lines. Yes, so these are all the strike lines. There is one more line. Okay, so these are all my strike lines. Now, for inclined bed map, we have to find out all these parameters. First is strike direction, then we will find out true dip direction and true dip amount, then apparent dip direction and apparent dip amount. So first we'll understand what is true dip and apparent dip. So here you can see, if this is the strike line, that SS, if it is a strike line, then this direction is called as the true dip. So what is true dip? It is always 90 degree to the strike or perpendicular to the strike. That is called as the true dip. So here, this is true dip, okay, 90 degree. Other than 90 degree, the remaining angles made by the dip with the strike, that is called as the apparent dip. So true dip is always 90 degree to the strike, and remaining directions, it may be any direction which is with respect to the strike line, that is called as the apparent dip direction. So here, first step we have solved, that is how to find the strike direction. So what is the direction of this line which we have drawn? This direction is parallel to the north direction, north-south line given. So here, what we will write, the strike direction as, okay, strike direction as north south, because these lines are parallel to the north south direction, so we have written it as north south. Then we'll find out the dip direction. So how to find the dip direction? So here, you have to take any one bedding plane, okay, any one bedding plane. I'll take this bedding plane. See the contour value intersection on this bedding plane. So here, the 700 contour is intersecting at this point. So I'll write the value 700 for this strike line at this point, okay. Next, as we are finding the dip direction, we are following the same bedding plane. So same bedding plane, next point, if you see, it is intersected by 800. So this is the 800 meters. Okay. So dip is always from higher contour to lower contour. So here this line value is 800 and the value of this line is 700. So your dip direction you have to represent like this. Okay, it is from higher contour to lower contour. So this is the direction. Okay, now dip direction. So here this arrow is pointing to which direction? This is pointing to the west. Okay, you can try it somewhere else also. On this side I'll show you. Okay, here you can see what is the value at this point. This is 700 for this line. Same bedding plane, next contour intersection is 800. So for this line I'll write value as 800. So dip is always from higher to lower. So this is the dip direction. Okay, so this is with respect to west. It is pointing towards west. Okay, so we will write it as west. Okay, so this is the true dip direction. We'll write it as due west. Okay, then first we'll find out what is apparent dip direction here. So this arrow is pointing to your x point. Okay, the xy line is given. So this is pointing towards x. So we will write the apparent dip direction as due x. Okay, then we will find the amount of the true dip. Okay, so how to find the amount? See here, you can take any number of lines which are equal. Okay, so here we will see the distance. We'll measure the distance between any number of lines which are equal. If you see here, the distance is not equal. Okay, so here how many centimeters it is coming? 6.6 centimeters. Okay, so to find the amount, there is one simple formula to find the dip amount. So dip amount is strike interval, that is SI, divided by contour interval into scale. Okay, so here we'll substitute the values. What is the strike interval we have got? So this is 6.6, is it? The distance between the equal strike lines, that is 6.6. okay, divided by number of divisions. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 divisions are. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 divisions from this point to this point, sorry, this point. Okay, so here you can take only one line also. Okay, so here if you see 1.1 divided by 1, that is also correct. Okay, but here for accuracy we will take maximum lines. Okay, so here what we got answer is 6.6 divided by 6. So that is the SI, 6.6 divided by 6 divided by the contour interval. Okay, so what is contour interval? The difference between any two successive contours, that is called as the contour interval. So if you take any two contours, two successive contours, what is the difference? Here it is 900, 800. So difference is 100. So that is the contour interval, that is 100 into the scale. Scale is given here, 1 centimeter equal to 100 meter. So this is 100. So what answer we got? This is 1.1. 100, 100 cancel. So as it is a slope, we will represent it as 1:1.1. This is the dip amount. So for true dip, okay, we are going to measure the perpendicular distance. So if you coincide this line, scale line, and your strike line, you will get the perpendicular distance between the lines. And to find apparent dip, okay, you have to join the xy line, okay, and measure the distance along xy line. Now here your xy line is perpendicular to the strike lines. So we will write the answer same for both. 1 is to 1.1 and this is also 1 is to 1.1. Okay. So this is the true dip and apparent dip amount. Okay. 1 is to 1.1. So this is the answer we got. Then next we'll move to draw. Okay. Draw the section along XY line. So to draw that, how we are going to do it? Like in previous map, how we did, same way we are going to do it now also. Okay. First mark all the points, all the intersecting points on the XY line. So first mark X and Y. Okay. Then the contours and the bedding planes we are going to mark. Don't mark the strike lines. Okay, only contours and beds we are going to plot it here. Okay. You can see the contours with small line, bedding planes with bigger lines you can mark. Okay. So this is how we are going to draw. So this is 700 contour. So I'll write 700. Next, there is a bed which is AB. Okay. So this side A and this side B. So this is the bedding plane of AB. Then this is 800 contour. Then next there is again a bed which is BC. Okay. Then again CD. Then the. So like this we will complete all the points. Okay. We will mark all the points here on the XY line. Then next what we have to do is we have to mark the contours. So here 700 means 7 centimeter. Then next 800, I'll measure 8 centimeter and the dot. Then next is 900, so 9 centimeters. Then 10, that is 1000 meters. Then again 900. Then 800 and the last one is 700. So we have plotted all the contours first. Then next we have to join all these contours with a smooth curve. Okay. So we are going to join all these points with a smooth curve. So like this. Join all the points with a smooth curve. Okay. Then next on X and Y we will draw one line, that is here the contours are decreasing. So after 700 we will mark 600 on Y. Okay. Draw a line. Okay. And join this point here. Then next on X also similarly 8, 7. So we will mark 6 here. And draw a line, okay, and join this point. So this is our profile. So by seeing the map, we had said the topography of that map is, it represents the hill. Now can you, you can see a profile of a hill here, okay. And I had told you also that here in the eastern side, the slope is steep and western side the slope is gentle. So here you can understand, here there is a gentle slope and here there is a steep slope. So now next job is to find or to draw the beds. Okay. So here there are A, B, C, D up to G, there are beds. So how to draw these beds? First we will transfer all these beds at the top of the profile. Okay. Will transfer all the beds at the top of the profile. A, B, B, C, C, D, D, E and E, F and the last one is F, G. Now as these beds are inclined, we are going to take the slope. So how to draw the inclined beds? So these we have calculated. So here we are going to take apparent dip direction and apparent dip amount. So our apparent dip direction is due x and apparent dip amount is 1:1.1. So as it is x, so we will take slope on x, and what is the amount? It is 1.1. So here on the xy line we'll mark the answer, that is the slope 1.1. So here you have to mark 1.1 on the xy line and 1 centimeter, 1:1.1. So 1 centimeter on the at the bottom. Okay, so if you join these 2 points, 1.1 and 1 centimeter, remember 1.1 we will take on xy line. So this is the slope which we got. Okay, so this is the slope to which these beds are dipping. Okay, so this is the dip amount and dip direction we have marked. Then next is to draw these beds which are inclined. So what we will do, I'll keep first the set square parallel to this slope, then take one more set square, okay, fix it here like this, and so this is parallel to this line we are going to draw all the beds. So here the first bed like this, okay, then next, then the next, okay. So like this, parallel to that slope we will draw all the beds. Yes, so these are all the beds so this is AB, means this bed is A and this is B. Then this is the line of BC. Okay, so this is BC bed. So this is B and this is C. Then D, E, F and G. So these are the beds. Now which is younger and older bed here? The younger bed is at the top and older bed at the bottom. So this is called as order of superposition, and that we represent in the index here. So beds and thickness. Okay, so the first bed, that is younger bed, always you have to write at the top. So this is A bed. Okay, then next is B, C, D, E, F and G. So these are the beds. Now you can measure the thickness here and write it. Okay, so here it is thickness of each bed. So first and last will be always unknown. Okay, so here we can measure and write the thickness. So here it is 8 centimeters, so you can write it as 80. Okay, then next bed is, the bed C is 70. Okay, then the next one is 130. Like this you can measure the distance and write it. 250, and the next one is almost 290. Okay, so this is the thickness of the beds. Now on the map there are questions given. So first draw a section along xy line that we have drawn. Okay, this is the section along xy line. So geological map 2, section along xy, and this map represents the inclined beds. Then next we will solve this. A horizontal tunnel is aligned at an elevation of 700 meters. Okay, comment on its stability. So here comes the engineering aspect. So what is given here? At 700 meter elevation there is a alignment of tunnel, and we have to comment on the stability of that tunnel. So if you propose a tunnel here in this hill, what is the advantages and disadvantages we are going to discuss. So the height given is 700 meter. So this is our 700 contour and this is the 700. So if you draw a tunnel alignment here, okay, I'll draw a line here which shows the tunnel alignment. So this is the tunnel alignment. Now if you construct a tunnel along this line, what problems you are going to face, that we are going to tell now. So as a civil engineer, you must see what is the geology of that particular area before going for any type of construction. So here we are going to construct a tunnel. So if you see the slope here, okay, it is gentle on this side and steep on this side. And if you propose a tunnel here, the beds which are present in this area, okay, they are dipping almost parallel to the slope. So what will happen? There are chances of landslides because the slope and the beds, okay, the slope and the beds, they are dipping in the same direction. So there are chances of landslides, okay. And one more point here to discuss is, if you see the length of the tunnel, okay, throughout the length of the tunnel, you are intersecting the beds, or the bedding planes are intersecting throughout the length of the tunnel, which is again problematic during rainy season. What will happen? The water may percolate along these bedding planes, and this will again create problem for the tunnel. So this is not safe. If you want to construct a tunnel here, you have to provide proper lining so that you can avoid the problem of percolation of or seepage of the water. So this is the comment on the stability of the tunnel. Okay, then describe the topography, geology and history of the area. Like previous map how we have discussed, here we are also going to discuss the geology, okay, then topography and the history of the map. So topography we are going to write with respect to this map. So I have told you how to write the topography. So this area represents a hill, okay, and on the eastern side the slope is steep, and on the western side the slope is gentle. The maximum elevation is 1000 meters and minimum is 600 meters. So this is, we are going to write in topography of the area. Then in geology of the area, what we are going to write? So this map represents a single inclined series of beds. They are conformable beds. So here the area represents single conformable inclined series of beds A, B, C, D, E, F, G, okay, of which A is the younger bed and G is the older bed. Then we are going to write here the order of superposition, that is nothing but this index, okay, and the attitude of beds, that is nothing but the dip and strike. So dip and strike, what we have calculated here, okay, this we are going to write in the geology of the area, okay, index and this. So here order of superposition and the attitude of beds are given below, so we will write it here. Then the last point is the geological history. So history we will write like this: during sedimentation in an oceanic basin, okay, what happened first? By various geological agencies, the bed G was deposited first because it is older bed. So this was deposited first, above which the bed E, F, E, D, C, B and A were deposited one above the other successively. Then what happened after deposition? Due to tectonic activity, all beds were uplifted. Okay, then they are exposed to the atmosphere and they are eroded by again different erosion agents like wind, water. Okay, and now they are showing the present geological or features. Okay, so like this we are going to write. Then lastly we are going to write the stability of tunnel. Okay, so the tunnel which is aligned at 700 meters. Okay, so here comment on the stability of this tunnel, like the slope. Okay, slope of the ground and the slope of the bedding planes, it is in the same direction, so there are chances of landslides. Then as the tunnel is all along the length of the tunnel, the bedding planes are intersecting, so there may be a problem of seepage during the rainy season. Okay, and there is a possibility of landslide because of this reason. Okay, so these two comments we are going to write about the alignment of the tunnel.